Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and happy Saturday. I am outside of the grocery store. It's about 6:30 in the morning. My particular store opens up at 7, so I'm just gonna relax, watch a little YouTube, sip on my coffee before I head in to do my grocery shopping. So you're going to see a grocery haul this week from Trader Joe's, Walmart, and Fred Meyer. So you're getting a triple threat of grocery hauls. Just because I did have to pick up quite a few things from some different stores this week, so you're gonna get quite a large grocery haul coming your way. So if you wanna see what I picked up to stay on track this next week, what's in store for meal prep and meal planning, because I am gonna show you my meal plan at the end of the video, then all you have to do is stay tuned. So here is the Walmart portion of my grocery haul. There was a couple of substitutions, so I'll let you know what those are. I did do Walmart grocery pickup. So I grabbed a case of water. Walmart has a really good price on their water. I do prefer to buy it at Costco, but I don't always make it to Costco. So 35 bottles, and I wanna say it was about $4 at Walmart. I also grabbed a pack of Pepsi Wild Cherry, the zero sugar. I don't know, it just sounded really good. Normally I like Coke Zero or Diet Pepsi. I do like to have a can of pop every night with dinner, so this 12 pack will last me a couple of weeks. Also grabbed some more of my all-time favorite creamer. This is the sugar-free Italian sweet cream creamer. I don't know why my camera does not want to focus. There we go. But this creamer is delicious. You can have up to 3 tablespoons for 1 SmartPoint. Also, I love this Hershey's whipped topping. So whenever I do a Walmart grocery pickup, I will go ahead and grab a can of the Hershey's whipped topping. It's 0 points, so I'll show you the nutritional here. So 2 tablespoons is only 10 calories. So I think you can have 2 or 3 tablespoons for 0 points. Also restock my PB2. I prefer the PB2 brand in this huge container. This is a 16-ounce container. It's only $8 or $9 at Walmart. So picked up some more PB2. I was about out. I've been loving the cheddar cheese pasta. Now I ordered the elbows, the macaroni and cheese. That's my very favorite, but they were out. So they substituted with the penne with cheddar cheese sauce. This one is good, but in my opinion, the mac and cheese one from Bird's Eye is better. But I took it because I do like it, and it's nice just to have it on hand as a side dish. You can have 1 serving for only 5 SmartPoints, so not bad. Now, I have been wanting to try this Nature's Own Butter Bread. Fred Meyer does not have it. I actually went on their website to see who had it. This bread is big slices, thick slices. 1 slice is 1 SmartPoint, 2 slices is 3. So I'm really excited to have a good bread, not that thin stuff of the Sara Lee. I don't like that. That's why I never buy it. And this is pretty thick, good sized loaf of bread, and so it was like $2 at Walmart, so really excited about that. As you know, I love having the no sugar added cherry pie filling for dessert. I just really like this. It tastes delicious. I usually will top it with some Lily's chocolate chips and some whipped topping, like this would be delicious on there. So this is really, really, you can have quite a bit for 2 to 3 SmartPoints, so I picked up 2 cans. Also, I had ordered the lemon meringue or lemon cream, I'm not sure what it's called, but the lemon light and fit Greek yogurt, and they were out, so they substituted with the coconut, toasted coconut vanilla, which is fine. I'll take it. I just needed a couple of yogurts. And then the last thing I got at Walmart was my favorite seasoning, which is the garlic parm. I don't use this for wings. I use this on other things. It's absolutely delicious on potatoes, chicken, so I grabbed another package of that. So that's everything from Walmart. So let's move into my Fred Meyer or Kroger haul. So here is the Fred Meyer or Kroger portion of this week's grocery haul. So first I grabbed a container of the Simple Truth Organic Free Range Low Sodium Chicken Broth. This is for a couple of dinner recipes this upcoming week. And just a reminder, we are doing the challenge on my Facebook group. So all of my recipes for the challenge will be included in an upcoming 5 nights of dinner. So you'll get to see all of these delicious recipes. So some free range chicken broth. I had a coupon for the Annie's mac and cheese. This is just kind of for my hubby if he wants a quick, easy dinner. These were buy one, get one free. So it was $1 for 2 boxes, which is a really good deal.
I also grabbed my husband some flour tortillas. He wanted to have soft tacos for lunches this next week. And I thought I would just show you everything, give you the points for everything. And then that way, if you are okay spending the points on these items, you'll know how many points they are. So these are the very large burrito size flour tortillas. We're also making a pizza this next week. I'm gonna do 2-ingredient dough. So I picked up this classic thin and crispy pizza crust for my husband. There's actually 2 of these in a pack. He does like thin crust. So I grabbed those. I may make both pizzas. If not, I'll throw the other crust into the freezer. Fat-free zesty Italian craft dressing. This is for an upcoming dinner recipe. I was completely out of Dijon mustard from making that delicious chicken salad, so I just restocked my Dijon mustard. I really like this Simple Truth organic brand. It's super good. Also, I had a coupon for kombucha, so I picked up 2 bottles. I'm working on one right now, and this is the Passion Berry Bliss. This is another one of my favorite kombuchas. I really like this GT's Synergy brand, so I grabbed that. I'll just pop it in the fridge, probably for next weekend. Of course, fat-free Ready Whip. I'm actually completely out, so I grabbed another can of that. Fred Meyer had their Starbucks iced coffee on sale, so I enjoy the blonde roast at Starbucks. I don't really care for the other blends. I think they taste burnt, but I don't mind the blonde roast. This is just unsweetened iced coffee. So if I'm looking for a quick cup of coffee to take on the road, I thought I would grab this. It was $2.99, which is a pretty darn good deal. Also picked up a can of pineapple tidbits. I'm gonna be needing this for an upcoming recipe. Kraft triple cheddar cheese. This is for those tacos for my husband. I know a lot of people are switching over from light and fat-free cheeses, so I wanted to give you the points value if you went with a full fat shredded cheese. So this will be for him for his tacos. I also grabbed him some string cheese. So this is just the regular low moisture part skim mozzarella cheese sticks. This is the big ginormous pack. He usually takes 2 a day. So I grabbed the mozzarella cheese sticks. And then I picked up this Smithfield diced ham. This is just to throw in the freezer. It was a really good sale price. And then I had a coupon in addition to that. So I'm just gonna toss it in the freezer. I use this a lot in recipes. My husband likes this macaroni salad I make with diced ham. So it'll last a long time in the freezer. So I just picked it up since it was on such a good deal. And the rest of what I grabbed is 0 point food. So I have a dozen of the Pete and Jerry's organic eggs. I actually really like this brand. They're usually pretty pricey, $6.99, $7.99 a dozen, but they were on sale for $4.99, and then I had a dollar off coupon, so it ended up being $3.99. And then I picked up another thing of my Happy Eggs. This is actually my very favorite egg, and these were $4.99 a dozen. 2 stalks of celery for a recipe, 2 onions. I've been really enjoying the sweet onions, so I grabbed 2 of those. An orange for an upcoming dinner recipe. Some baby carrots. This is for recipe as well as for snacking. Lots of bell peppers, 2 green, an orange, and a red, also for an upcoming recipe. Then I was excited to find these carrot chips. I've been looking all over for these. Fred Meyer never has them, and then randomly today they did. I love these. I don't know what it is, but I like eating my carrots in chip form. I can dip these in hummus or dips, and I don't know, I just really like the chips. So I grabbed a bag of those. Cherries were on sale for $1.99 a pound. So I grabbed, I think it was, it ended up being a couple pound bag. And lastly, a fresh pineapple, and this is for an upcoming dinner recipe. So let me take you over, show you the drinks that I purchased for the week. So at Fred Meyer, they had their Diet Coke 3 for $11. So I picked up 2 packs of Diet Coke for my husband and then a 12 pack of Coke Vanilla Zero for me. This will last me a couple of weeks. So I always just grab one when I'm running low. And then also Fred Meyer had their Lipton Tea 12 packs on sale for $2.99. And this is 0 calories, so 0 points. And this is the Diet Green Tea Citrus. So that's what I picked up from Fred Meyer for drinks for the week. So here's what I picked up at Trader Joe's. So I just grabbed a few things. So first I wanted to get some coconut aminos, and these are the least expensive at Trader Joe's by far. These are organic and they are excellent. So I grabbed a bottle of that. I also was completely out of regular balsamic vinegar. I only have the white balsamic. So this literally was like $3. And it, again, it's excellent. Their sauces are so good. So I picked up some balsamic vinegar. And I also grabbed another bottle of my toasted sesame oil. Again, one of my favorite things at Trader Joe's. I use this a lot in Chinese food or Asian food. It adds an excellent, excellent flavor. And I am in love with this Trader Joe's smoked turkey breast, all natural ingredients, zero smart points. It is so good. It tastes like you sliced it right off of a cooked turkey. I mean, it's that incredibly good. It doesn't have any weird lunch meat taste. Love it. So I grabbed it. It was $2.99. As you know, I love their extra lean ground beef, so I picked up two more packs of the 96.4. I love this because you can have 4 ounces for 2 smart points, I believe. Of course, it'll be here on the screen. Best ground beef, best price in my area. Also, because they no longer have the light shredded mozzarella, very sad day, I picked up a bag of the fancy shredded light Mexican blend. I like to have this on hand. And I saw this, one of my subscribers said that this organic shredded mozzarella cheese was pretty close to the light. This one is actually 2 smart points per serving for a quarter of a cup versus 1 smart point, but it's expensive. It's $5 for this little 8 ounce bag. But you know, I've got pizza coming down the pipe next week for my challenge, so I went ahead and grabbed it. I'm gonna try it. Let's see if I like it. I am definitely going to miss the light shredded mozzarella cheese. And then I grabbed a watermelon. Trader Joe's watermelons are super duper good. So that is everything from Trader Joe's. So moving on to this week's meal plan and what's on the agenda for meal prep. Here is my meal planner. This is the Carrie L. As you guys know, I love my meal planner so much. This is the 8.5 by 11. It is just absolutely gorgeous, comprehensive, has everything you'd ever need. You've got some tabs here on the side. One of them is for resources. This is where you can log your favorite meal planning blogs and recipes. That way they're right at your fingertips. There's an inventory section where you can inventory your freezer, your fridge, your pantry. Meal plans, we'll come back to that one. That's the one we're gonna focus on. There's a gatherings tab, and this is where you can plan an event. So you can list out what you're planning on preparing for the event and then prepare a grocery list as well. So it makes it really, really easy. And then lastly, there is a notes tab. And this is where I will jot down recipes that I find online that I don't print off. And then that way I have them at my fingertips. And then also in the back is this cute little folder pocket where you can put some of your favorite things. So let's move into the meal plans tab, which is obviously the one that we use the absolute most. So first let's go to the monthly planner. So this is for July. So what I will do is I will list out what I'm planning on making for dinner each night so that at a glance I can see what is on my menu, make sure I pull out my meat out of the freezer and that I have all of the ingredients on hand. So it's just a really fast, quick look to make sure that I'm ready to go for that night's dinner. And then each week you will have a weekly menu where you can list out what is on your meal plan for each day. You can list breakfast, lunch, dinner, whatever you prefer on your weekly menu. And then there is a detachable grocery list here to plan what you need to pick up from the store. I use my grocery list every single week. So here is what is on my plan for this week. You can see the grocery list is missing. So my week goes from Saturday through Friday. This is the week of my challenge on my Facebook group. So really excited for that. I'll put my Facebook group here on the screen for you if you're interested in joining. We are just shy of 7,000 members. So come on over and join the fun. So today is Saturday. We are going to be having a farmhouse chicken dinner. Tomorrow, we'll just do some leftovers. Monday is ground beef casserole with some vegetables. This is actually a low carb dinner. It is also keto friendly if you don't pair it with any type of starch. So excited to have that. Tuesday, I'm making barbecue chicken pizzas. Sounds amazing. Wednesday is skinny orange chicken with jasmine rice and vegetables. So kind of a copycat of a Cheesecake Factory orange chicken, but WW friendly. Thursday is Hawaiian sheet pan chicken. This sounds amazing. And then next Friday, which is the end of the challenge, basically ends on Thursday. So Friday we'll just eat leftovers of whatever was left from the prior week. So that's what's on my meal plan. And then on the back of the meal plan is where I will plan for meal prep. So again, this week is my challenge. So for breakfast this week, I'm gonna be making a hash brown casserole, and that it will last me the entire week of the challenge. And I'm gonna pair that with some fruit. For lunches this week, I'm gonna be making turkey meatloaf muffins. These are so good. I've made these before. I cannot wait to share the recipe with you. And then I'm also going to be making a broccoli bacon salad. That sounds delicious. So you're gonna get three recipes in this week's meal prep. Just no dessert because we have the menu all planned out with Smart Sweets, so we don't need to prepare a dessert item. So that is what is on meal prep, which you guys will see on Monday. So that is my meal plan and meal prep for the week. This is my Carryell meal planner. So if you are interested in this absolutely gorgeous meal planner, they have a ton of different covers. Go ahead and run over to carryell.com. Use my discount code here on the screen. You will get 10% off of your planner. So this definitely helps you not only plan your meals, but stay on track. So I highly recommend it. It is not dated, so you can order it now and it'll last you over a year. So definitely check out the Carryell meal planner. Thank you for joining me on another weekly WW grocery haul. I hope you enjoyed seeing my huge haul from Walmart, Trader Joe's, and Fred Meyer. Everything I need to stay on track and have another successful week on Freestyle. So if you're new to my channel, I'd like to extend a huge warm welcome. Please make sure that you subscribe, and if you hit that little bell, you'll be notified every time I upload so you don't miss a single video. I'd love it if you'd thumbs up this one. Comment down below. Let me know, was there anything new that I showed you today that you didn't know was WW friendly or you never thought of picking up for your journey? And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye.